بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. In our previous clip, we spoke about the liberation of Makkah, the Fath al-Makkah, and we identified one quality which stood out, and that was the humility in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the humble manner in which he entered Makkah, with 10,000 strong companions with him. He entered with his head bowed down. He reminded people that he was a human being who came from a woman who ate dried meat. Abu Sufyan, witnessing the prayer, the wudu, was in such so much awe, seeing the companions competing for the water that fell from the blessed limbs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam like pearls. It dropped, and they rushed for it for the barakah. We ended off saying that Abu Sufyan commented, saying, "O Abbas, I have never seen anything like I have witnessed tonight, not even in the kingdoms of Caesar." Humility is a quality. It is a quality which raises a believer in ranks. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "لا يدخل الجنة من في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر." No one will enter paradise as long as they have an ounce or an atom's weight of arrogance in their heart. وَلَا يَدَخُلُ النَّارِ مَنْ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ مِنْ إِيمَانٍ. None shall enter the fire so long as they have an atom's weight of faith in their heart. فَقَالَ رَجُلْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ يُحِبُّ أَنْ يَكُونَ ثَوْبَهُ حَسَنًا. A man then called out, "O Messenger of God, from amongst us are those who love to wear beautiful garments and clothing." The Prophet responded, "إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى جَمِيلٌ يُحِبُّ الْجَمَالِ." Allah indeed is beauty, and He loves beauty. الْكِبْرُ بَطْرُ الْحَقِّ وَغَمْسُ النَّاسِ. Arrogance is rejecting the truth and belittling people, thinking low of people. Remember that kibr, arrogance, is rejecting the truth and belittling people. It is narrated by Abu al-Qasim al-Kushayri, the wali of the awliya in the third century, who wrote one of the first orthodox works on tasawuf, the Risala al-Kushayriya, that he records the wali of the awliya, Abu Yazid al-Bistami rahimahullah ta'ala, who was asked, "متى يكون الرجل متواضعا?" When does a person gain the quality of humility, tawadu? When does he become humble? فقال, and he replied, "إذا لم يرى نفسه مقاما ولا حالا." When he no longer sees himself as having a high station or a lofty hal, condition, state, spiritual state. ولا يرى أن في الخلق من هو شر منه. And so long as he does not see amongst the creation one who is more bad than he is himself. In other words, he keeps the window open for the possibility that he is worse than other people, and other people may be better than him, and he does not see himself as having a high, lofty station. So he leaves room to achieve it and to work toward it. I end off with a well-known narration from amongst the Sahaba, between Zayd bin Thabit and Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma. Qil, it was narrated. Rakiba Zayd bin Thabit. Zayd bin Thabit was riding his horse or his ride. Fadana ibn Abbas liya'khudha birukabihi. And Abdullah ibn Abbas took the reins of the horse, of his beast, and kept it down so that Zayd could descend from the horse down to the ground. Faqala lahu ma. Ya ibn Am Rasulullah, said, "What are you doing, O nephew of the Prophet of Allah?" Faqal, and Zayd responds by saying, "Hakada." Ibn Abbas responds by saying to Zayd, "Hakada amarana an naf'al bi'ulama'ina." This is what the Prophet of Allah commanded us to do, and how to respect our scholars. Because Zayd was a scholar. He was a scholar in his own right. And that is how Ibn Abbas respected him. فَأَخَذَ زَيْد بِنْ ثَابِتْ يَدْ Ibn Abbas فَقَبَّلَهَا. And what happened was Zayd bin Thabit, when he got off the horse, grabbed the hands of Ibn Abbas and kissed his hands. وَقَالَ, and Zayd said to Ibn Abbas, هَكَذَا أَمَرَنَا أَن نَفْعَلْ بِأَهْلِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. Me kissing your hands is exactly what the Prophet peace be upon him, commanded us to do and how to respect the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Finally, it is recorded by Imam Ibrahim Bayjuri in his Hashia, which is a detailed commentary on the poem written by Imam Laqani, a book on theology, a beautiful hadith where the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentions all the angels that are deputized to look after each human being. And he says there's one angel on the lips that permanently remains on the lips of the human being, and that angel's duty is to record salawat that we send upon the Prophet, peace be upon him. Sending salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a sign of humility to the best of creation, acknowledging his rank and how we are elevated through elevating him on our lips, in our hearts, and in our minds. He then goes on to say that there's an angel on the back, the nape of the neck, and that angel's duty is to elevate someone who is humble and to smack down the arrogant person in the spiritual realm. So remember, tawadu, humility, is what elevates us. Kibr, arrogance, is what debases us. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa barik wa sallim walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.